Hey everybody, what's up? This is Devin and Michelle Lavour, and today we wanted to address the topic of why we feel called to go to Nashville, okay? And of course, the baby's sleeping there. He might enter the video at some point.
Yeah.
But last night, you know, we were, you want to tell them what was going on last night with us?
Well, last night we were just kind of, I guess, just wondering, you know, is Nashville really where God wants us to be? And just kind of putting that out there. Because I think for both of us, it's something like, you know, we just had this twinge of like, well, maybe it's not, you know, because it's just been a long road. And so we really wanted to ask God, like, hey,
is, get some clarification.
Yeah, just get some clarification.
We really wanted to get this thing settled because we were tired of fighting with it.
Yeah, because it's come up before and we've gone through things. So we just prayed and asked God, like, hey, can you just really make it clear to us, is this where you want us to be? And
because we're not going to look up a scripture and say, and it's going to be like, Devin and Michelle shall go to Nashville one day. We'd be famous. You know what I'm saying? And you're the Devin and Michelle from the Bible. Oh my gosh. Do you know you're going to Nashville? Have you read the word? You know what I mean? It's like,
that would be awesome. But, and then, and that was kind of, it was just an interesting night too, because it was like, well, what could God do for us that would really show us that, yes, we're going to Nashville? And I was just like, well, it'd be really awesome if, you know, somebody who didn't know that we wanted to go to Nashville, which is pretty much nobody we know.
We put that out there, you know.
I was like, well, you know, if somebody who didn't know what we were thinking could tell us that we're going to Nashville, that would be awesome. But it was like, I don't know, you know. But we just were kind of just let God.
Well, and I felt like in that process, I felt like God was like, or I could just take you there and then you will see. But I was like, come on, bro. But I'm getting ahead of myself.
Yeah. So why don't you go ahead and share
that part?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, because I was like, because what we wanted was like, we wanted some, we wanted to settle this. We wanted to kind of bury the hatchet. It was like constantly, like, even John the Baptist, who baptized Jesus, and he was a part of that whole experience, you know, of baptizing Jesus, and he's the Lamb of God. He prophesied that he's the Lamb of God and all that. And then things started happening in a way that John was like, well, what's this? This is not, because even John was captured by the cultural expectation that every other Jew had, thinking, oh, the Messiah's here. This is what's going to happen. Yay!
Yeah.
And it was just like, what? Why is this happening like this, you know? And then later on, he was like, you know what? Can you go ask him, are you really the one, or should we expect another? Even he doubted. You know, even he had that sense of like, and that's what we were dealing with. And we were like, okay, Lord, I just want to bury this thing.
Yeah.
You know, if we're not supposed to be there, I don't want to, who cares about any particular geographical location? Who cares?
Yeah.
It's like, what do you want us to do? What, you know, and from that, I was expecting, you know, maybe God will give my wife a dream later that night. Or
not likely. Not when you conk out because your child stays up until, you know, 2 a.m.
Right. And then you're getting up at like 9 or 10 and it's just like, what? And it's like, what? Did you have any dreams?
No.
I don't even remember sleeping.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, so I was like, okay, and I'll just give you a couple days to answer the question or whatever. And right away, the Lord was like, you know, because I wasn't really sure if that word of like, well, I could just take you there. And I wasn't really sure. I was just like, I don't know if that's the Lord, because that doesn't satisfy what we're trying to get satisfied here.
Oh, and that was the other thing we were asking. Like, we really want to have scripture to back up whatever you're telling us.
Yeah, I was like, we need a word. And I know we're not going to find something in the word that has our name on it in Nashville. And I was like, okay. And then I felt like the Lord, right away, I felt like the Lord wanted me to make this map. I got this little map going on here. Probably can't see it. But, God showed me, like, how he began to show us the story and all the different things that we had forgotten mm-hmm. on how we ended up yep. at Nashville. Mm-hmm. And do you want to tell them some of this part here? Or?
Yeah, so I guess we just...
When we first started.
Yeah, when we first started, we did feel like we God wanted us to move. Mm-hmm. And so we originally, you know, we're actually kind of both... have been lived in the West Coast.
I'm from the United States.
Yeah.
He's I've been moved to about the West 70 Coast. Times. So
but it was like so when we first started kind of thinking that when we were moving, we're like, all right, let's I was super excited. I'm like, okay, we can go west. I like the West. It's really gorgeous. It's beautiful. The weather, awesome. Yay. And so
I love it. Yay.
And so just a couple of the key things for us we looked at when we were looking at different states were kind of their homeschooling laws and also like taxes.
And an environment that would give us freedom to do the vision God put on our heart. Yeah. You know?
So we ended up looking a lot at like Utah and oh my gosh, they have gorgeous homes.
Because we were looking for states that didn't have state taxes to them.
Yeah.
Because it was like, dude, these state taxes and the federal taxes, I mean, they just kill you.
Yeah.
They take a lot of these states, they take, when you start making really good money, they take over half your money.
Yeah.
You know?
So we started looking there and, you know, it was exciting. We got to see all these really gorgeous houses and all this stuff.
Oh, in Utah?
In Utah.
Yeah. Well, because it boiled down to four states.
Yeah.
But then we eliminated two of them, and we ended up with Utah and Tennessee. Yeah.
And
I think they needed that part.
So, but we really, like, you know, we were seeking God about it, and he really just made it clear to us that, you know, going to Utah, it would basically be going to a desert. And
yeah, because the Lord told me, the Lord was strong on me on that. He was just like, no, like, you don't want to go there. I know it's better than just about any other place you've seen, like, as far as the taxes are concerned, homeschooling laws, yeah. and the scenery. Yeah, it's amazing. It's just, I don't want you to go there.
Yeah.
You know?
And we just felt like, just for us, it would be a very desert place.
Well, because the Lord told me, he was like, do you want to go from the wilderness to the wilderness? And I was like, no, thank you.
Yeah, no. So that got... taken away, and then we
much
were...
Much to your dismay.
It was. And so then we looked into Tennessee, and mm-hmm. just like the Nashville area, and, you know, looking into it, it's like we discovered, wow, it's like one of the biggest areas for like publishing, mm-hmm. Christian publishing
music
houses and music.
And books, which is what we do.
Yeah.
You know?
So,
that's our vision, really.
And their homeschooling laws, just, they're not horrendous or anything.
Yeah,
so
they're pretty good. They're going to allow you to freely educate your kid yeah. the way you want to.
And, so that's kind of how we ended up coming over to the Tennessee area.
And can I touch on this? Because I was like, Lord, why are you showing us this storyline and all that? And he reminded me of Ruth and Esther mm-hmm. and how you don't find God in that book going, and God did this and God orchestrated that and God said this and gave this prophetic word and sent this prophet into the person's life to say this, that, and everything. But you can clearly see God was all over those stories. That's why they're in there, to show like, man, God can be working behind the scenes, moving chess pieces, moving your heart, moving the certain, you know what I mean, in order to get you to where he wants to get you. And that was the whole point. God, I felt like God was like that right there. You thought that was you guys just using your mind and your common sense and all that stuff. And I was like, that was just me orchestrating things the whole time. Just to show you, like, I am pointing you in that direction. Yeah. Nashville, Tennessee. And he reminded me of, because I got Nashville up there, and he showed me this little pillar that was in Nashville, and he's like, and he reminded me of the vision my wife had about seeing us as pillars in Nashville, mm-hmm. and he's like, remember that? Because a lot of times we forget this stuff, we forget it all, how it all connects, but there's more coming.
Yeah.
But then the Lord also gave me a scripture. Here he is, he's just kind of encouraging our spirit with the story, building up our faith. And the Lord told me, he was like, listen, Devin, no matter how much I share with you tonight, no matter how much, I mean, because the Lord just was pouring out on me, wasn't he? It was intense.
Yeah.
And it was like, no matter how much the outpouring is, you're not going to take the faith part out of this.
Yeah.
You have to believe, like, I'm sharing this with you. You have to believe it and then step out on it. And so he gave me Exodus 3:12, and that was the scripture where and the Lord's been speaking the word sign to us a lot lately. Like, mm-hmm. this is a sign, and he's been reminding us that our son is a sign of what he's getting ready to do. And we just had a big old fat sign on Monday, the total eclipse thing. And I just felt like the Lord shared with me that, and I had to crack up, because that is not the kind of sign I want. Because the sign that he gave Moses, because Moses was like, well, how will I know that you're sending me? And Moses was like, well, this will be the, and God was like, this will be the sign to you. When you go and you get those people, you'll bring them back here and you'll worship on this mountain. There you go. And I'm like, hold on. When do you need the sign, babe?
Usually you want it before.
Before, thank you. Not after. It's like, hello. And I'm like, what? That is God's sense of humor, even in that moment with Moses. It's like, really, dude? And now he's giving that to me. He's like, you wanted scripture? I'm giving you a scripture. It's like, trust me, there's going to be a sign. But then this is the thing. God was like, you're going to come and you're going to worship on this mountain. Oh my gosh, it just blew my mind when he said that, because then he immediately reminded me of that vision he gave me of scooping our family out of the cave and setting us on a mountain. And he was like, and then not only that, but he reminded me of the seven mountains thing that I had touched on in another video. And he was like, that's the mountain I'm placing you on. And he was like, that mountain, the kind of mountain that I want to place you on, is in Nashville, Tennessee.
Yeah.
You know, there's a huge, that's a huge mountain of Christian publishing, particularly for the kind of stuff I write, which is the sci-fi, speculative, you know, nerdy hero stuff that I love to write. And not only that, but the music, the Christian music and the worship music, I do both of that. I mean, just everything that is me, everything that is her, mm-hmm. it totally fits on this mountain of influence. And God, so it's like, it opened my mind even to that previous vision of how he's going to actually scoop us and put us on I thought it was just going to be like a mountain of blessing or something, or just, Nashville was the mountain.
I thought it was like a picture, you know, like, oh, God's placing you on the mountain.
Yeah,
and like
Nashville is that mountain and whatever.
Yeah.
But it's actually Nashville. It's, yes, geographically, but spiritually, it's that very mountain of influence that is there in that area,
mm-hmm.
you know? And I felt like the Lord said, that's going to be your sign.
Yeah.
Here's your sign.
Yeah. So kind of after that revelation of what the mountain is, it just really firmly put it in our hearts that, yes, God has called us to go to Nashville. And so that's
And I really felt like the Lord wanted me to draw this out.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, draw this out because you're going to need to see this and reference it.
Yeah.
And it was on the same page that we have all of our re's.
Yeah.
all of the things.
All of the repeats that God has
all the things he's been repeating to us.
So it's been, it was just definitely really awesome, because it was like God answered the question.
Right away.
And he gave us this like confirmation, gave us scripture. And so it was just really awesome last night. And
We believe the door that God, that we're standing in front of, is going to lead to here.
Yeah.
That's why we've been asking. We've been like, Lord, I don't understand. We just need to settle this. And I tell you what, man, we prayed, God answered, and it is settled, man.
Yeah.
That is where we're going. That's why I titled this, Why Nashville? The Prophetic Evidence. Because there's just a long history of God working mm-hmm. in our lives to point us in that direction.
Yeah.
Like the whole arrow vision. I felt like God gave me that vision of that arrow. We're like an arrow, and he's pointing us. That arrow is pointed at Nashville.
Yeah.
You know?
So that's why Nashville.
Yeah. You know, and the thing is, God's probably got a prophetic history and a prophetic story in your life that's not hard to follow. It's like kind of like breadcrumbs that, oh, this is what you're leading. And you've probably forgot 50% of those breadcrumbs. And if you go back through your story and you just follow it, you'll see what God's doing, right?
Yeah. So just thanks for joining us and kind of listening to us as we share more of our story. And we just hope that this was encouraging to you guys. Maybe you can have some takeaway from this. And we will see you again next time. See ya.
Follow the yellow brick road.